Encore is a framework for rapidly building backend applications, and I want to give you a quick demo of what that looks like. What we're looking at here is a simple to-do list application, which consists of a single backend service with two APIs, one API for adding a to-do item, and a second one for returning a list of the ones that exist. We also have a database, which has a single table that has all the to-do items. And when you want to run this with Encore, you simply type Encore run. And it immediately spins up and registers our endpoints and is ready to go. It sets up the database, connects to it, you name it. So let's take a look at what this looks like. And here we have a simple demonstration front end just to better understand how it works. So here, we can add to-do items, for example, buy groceries, maybe we want to cook dinner and eat dinner. So as you can see, we've added them, and when we reload, they're still there. And that's because they were sent to our backend that stored them in our database. Now, if you want to actually tick them off, that doesn't work. And the reason for that is we don't have any update functionality yet. So what I want to do now is I'm going to create that live. And to do that with Encore, you simply type a regular function declaration, and where the input is a data structure that will look like this, where we're taking the ID of the item we want to update, as well as the new done state. And we're going to add that as a parameter to our function. And the return is the updated item that the frontend will use to update the user interface. And let's construct the item based on the input. So we're going to copy over the ID. We're going to copy over the new done. And then for the title, we're going to query that from the database. And what we're going to do is we're going to update item, set done equals the input where ID is also from the input. Like so, and we'll return the title and read that into our updated item and return everything like so. And when we save, we can see that Encore automatically detects this, recompiles, and adds our new endpoint. And now that we take a look, now that we update them, we can see that it works. And when we refresh, it's all there. So everything is now updated in the database. Another thing that Encore does is it provides you with this really rich and powerful dashboard for local development, where you can see exactly the requests that were being made, and a very detailed distributed tracing view for understanding exactly what your application is doing. The request data, the response, as well as a very rich understanding of exactly what database queries were being made, and so on. You also get really rich API documentation, and all of this is generated completely from what you just saw. There's no step to generate this. It's just there based on the source code itself. So now that we have this, let's go ahead and instead of just running this locally, let's push it to production. And then we do git push Encore, and we can see that it has triggered a build. So with that, we can open it up, and this takes us to Encore's web platform, where we host a CI, CD, production environments, and so on. And here we are first going to compile it and run all the tests. And once this is done, it will automatically deploy. And once that's done, our application will be live in production. You also get access to the API documentation in the same way we just looked at. You get full access to the source code for easy finding something that you're looking for, and so on. So now we can see that it's deploying, it's updating the database, and it's already live. So now we can see that the new update functionality is live in production. So in order to demonstrate this, let's go ahead and connect to our database in production. So we're going to head over here, and instead of talking on localhost, let's grab our app ID and talk to our production environment instead. And that's as simple as just changing the URL. And when we refresh, we can see that we're now talking to the production environment. And here we can add a to-do item and tick it off. So that's all. That's a quick demo of just how easy it is to use Encore to build and deploy applications directly to production. Thank you so much, and have a great rest of your day.